What is up, beautiful people? YouTube, my name is Yuri Tasek, and today I'm going to be giving you a very in-depth tutorial to how to make your GTA 5 5M game run smoother. We're going to do a few things that are a little bit more advanced, a few things to look at the settings, and most importantly, we're going to do a few things that are pretty common sense, but just a reminder for you. The first step is actually recently I've been adopting this and it's been helping me out a lot is thanks. First of all, I got to give a shout out to my friend NotAgent for showing me this, but it's an NVIDIA control panel and it is limiting the frames rate. Now, this might be counterintuitive to some people who say, well, I have a pretty good computer. Why would I need to limit the frame rates? I'm going to tell you why in just a second. Regardless of it, here's my specs right here. As you can see, it's a 4080 Super with an i14-9900K. So pretty beefy computer, 32 gigs of RAM, should be just fine, right? However, you got to understand that this is a 12-year-old game. So the optimization of it and how things go doesn't always match with the specs of the computer, right? You can have a really good computer, but the game can only go so much, especially 5M. But let's take a look at this. Where do we go to limit the frame rates and why do we want to do this? First of all, you would go to your NVIDIA control panel by clicking here, NVIDIA control panel, to search for it. That's if you have NVIDIA, of course. Once you click on that, you're gonna go to manage 3D settings over here. You gotta go to program settings and you're gonna add it if it's not there, which most likely it's not gonna be there. And the one you wanna add is the subprocess slash 5M underscore B3095 underscore GTA process.exe. Now yours might be 2699 or it could be 2802. Depends on what version of 5M that you're on, but in my case it's a 3095. So that's what I'm putting in there. Then you wanna scroll down and locate the max frame rate, which goes by alphabetical order. In my case, I put 80 frames per second. You can play around with it and figure out which one works for you. Now again, the question might be, I have a pretty beefy computer. Why would I want to limit the frames per second? Actually, it might sound counterintuitive, but not really, because when you already set a max frame rate, your computer might operate at 120 frames, 130 frames in the game. However, the energy might be higher, the heat might be higher, the processes might be higher. Therefore, in the moments that you are getting frame rates over 100 to 110 to 120, 140 frames per second, you're really sacrificing in other areas. And over time in your gaming session, it will slow you down. Now, when you put a cap to that max frame rate, now you're rolling at a consistent balance, in this case, 80 frames per second. Now, okay, and as you can see in the top right corner, just to follow up an example I was giving you, now my frame rates are capped at 80 frames per second, so it's gonna give me a consistent base all around. I'm not gonna fluctuate between 121 minute, then my GPU being overworked or CPU being overworked, then I go back to 60, etc., so on and so forth. But now let's take a look at the in-game settings for your graphics here. So the first thing we want to take a look at is, again, it all depends on what card you have. You obviously want to utilize no more than really half of how many megabytes your video card can handle, okay? The render resolution, even though I have a 2K monitor, I do not put it above 1920 by 1080. That's render resolution. I'm not talking about the screen resolution. That is just a render resolution, okay? There's other things in here that I won't go really part for part on, because they're really kind of irrelevant to just making your 5M go a little bit better. This is all testing and all gonna vary to what video card you have, and we're not all gonna have the same video card. But there are a few things that I wanna mention. Another thing is the extended texture budget. Although that does raise your video memory usage, see when I play with it up and down. However, what this does is it gives the GPU, or gives the game, more permission to use more of the GPU resources, therefore to make your textures around you run a little bit smoother. So again, if you're running on like for example, a 2080 or a 3080, and you'll have only 8 megabytes of video memory, I would make sure that I'm staying at 4,000 or less, maybe 4,500. I don't like to use more than half of the video memory allocated to me when I'm using 5M, because again, not only that, you gotta take in mind is what kind of server are you on? Is it optimized or not? Which we'll talk about too in just a second. One of the things that really eat up a lot of the GPU and a lot of the CPU are reflections and shaders. So again, if you're running on a lower end to mid end PC, you don't want to go very high on this. You don't want to go ultra on the reflection. Water quality is another one you can sacrifice. You're not gonna really notice it unless you're near the water or in the water itself. And last but not least is grass quality. As you can see, even with my computer that is pretty damn good, my grass quality is not on high. Just because, again, that's unnecessary, unneeded stress on that. So that's what you do in the graphics. In the advanced graphics, what you wanna do is the following. The resolution here is whatever monitor you have, so you don't have to do anything on that. But again, as you can see, your highest resolutions, this you can sacrifice. Long shadows, I keep off because that really eats up a lot of frames and really slows things down for me. And as you can see, extended shadow distance. This really eats up a lot of frames for me as well. I keep this off, I keep this at medium. Because I do a lot of Air One stuff, I do keep high detail streaming while flying. That's only gonna be applicable if you do a lot of flying in your game. Otherwise, you're better off just keeping it off. And high resolution shadows, I keep it on. Again, I do like mine with a little bit shadows. My computer could handle it, but ensure and make sure that is in there. Okay, that's number two. Number three, it does really matter the type of server that you are on. Now, I am just gonna take my server for example and show you something here. I am not picking in anybody's server or anything like that, but one another way to kind of iron out what it is, what you see a lot of servers do, which is very mind-boggling to me, is when it comes to CIF cards, for example, let's go here, civilian cards and or EUP stuff. All our civilian cards are one resource. The more resources that you have running in your 5M server or in their 5M server in this case, the more stress is gonna put on the server, the more lag you will experience in the server. So another thing you could do is go to 5M server list, just Google that, or you can go to servers.5m.net, search the server you're playing in. And I know maybe you're not experienced in devving or anything like that, but take a look at it. If you see a lot of random car names in there, or a lot of random police car names in there, or just random things that are not really like MLOs or more than likely that server is not really optimizing it very well. Now, I'm not trying to plug my server here, but not too many servers take the time that we take to really even optimize the skins and the weapons and the clothes and the cars. Everything has been are optimized to be in a server to use as less memory and as less streaming memory as possible. So the number three thing is, a lot of people seem to forget, it's not always about you and your computer, but also what server you're playing on. And I guess if that would be 3A, 3B would be, also what server are you connecting to? I know there's a lot of avid UK role players that like the American style role play or the American style police cars. If the server is based, for example, in Buffalo, New York, or Houston, Texas, or is based in Portland, Oregon, wherever it's based, and you're connecting to it across the world, it is not going to be a very smooth thing for you. You probably will experience a lot of lag, a lot of latency, and a lot of crashes. So number four thing I want to tell you is to make sure your cache is clear every now and then. Now, I made a very simple 60-second tutorial on that, but I'll show you here real quickly as well. Let's go ahead and open up my 5M app data, which is right here. Once you go to your 5M app data, you'll go to data, and then you just delete all of those. I'm not gonna do that because I just did it, but that's where you go. Again, 5M app data, locate, and then go to data, then go right here. Delete those in the data. Now, why does that matter? Because when you are going on random servers and different servers, all this data, a lot of this stuff, sometimes even your HUD customization, sometimes other things, they just get stored locally. And the more servers you join, if they do share the same scripts, which if they're KubiCore ESX, they probably will, the more that data keeps compiled up. And sometimes it creates an internal conflict within your files. That's why it's important to update the data. Whenever we update a script, for example, a mechanic script and or even an advanced garage script that we have, those we notice will cause some issues for our members if they don't delete their local data or local cache. The fifth thing is, what do you have in the background when you are playing 5M? Obviously, a good way to go about this is to go here and click on this and see your memory usage and all this stuff. Now, this is happens to be mine. Obviously, right now, I'm not in 5M, but sometimes I'll go in here and remember that I forgot Discord open. Now, again, I have a pretty good, decent PC. I have one of the best CPUs, and only one GPU card currently on the market as the maker of this video is better than mine, which is a 4090, okay? But regardless of that, I still do my due diligence. If I'm on Discord and I'm playing a 5M and I'm not even chatting with my friends, I don't need to be on Discord. I'll just go ahead and exit out of that. If you have Chrome tabs open, if you have things in the background open, et cetera, so on and so forth, just be mindful of that when you go in. Just be mindful of what is your memory usage, what's your CPU usage, and be mindful of those things. Another thing I like to do is to go and start up the apps. As you can see, I have a lot of them disabled. None of them really start up with my computer. I don't need them to start up with my computer, so I just disable them. And to disable them, you simply right click either, like in this case, we can enable this, and then you just right click and disable it, right? Additionally speaking, I'm gonna put a few, just about five or six on the screen right now of services you can disable, but I would suggest disabling some services altogether that you're not using. Now, I don't want to go too deep into this because this is just goes into, I don't know what you use and what you don't use, but there are some services that generally you probably don't need to use if you're just using a computer like I am for video editing, playing video games, watching, you know, movies and videos and just general chatting with friends. I'm not really using my server for any like network stuff. I'm not using it as a server for other things. I'm not using it as a workstation. It's more so as a personal station slash gaming station. So like I said, I'm just going to post these five things that you can do. But otherwise, eliminating some services in the background, and this is something you can research on your own, could be easy. And by eliminating, I mean just stopping, not eliminating completely. And here's how to stop them. Again, go to your task manager. You would go to services. Up here, go open services. What you want to do, again, I'm trying to find something here that I'm not actually using. Let's say hypothetically, I want to disable print spooler, okay? I don't really even print from this computer. What you want to go is click on whatever you want to disable and just put disabled. And that's it. That's what you want to do. And you can even stop it yourself as well. But if you want to disable it altogether, just put disabled. Just also understand that the more some people for some reason run NVE with reshade with other graphic things, I am not sure why, but really you should limit yourself to just one graphics modification. In my case, I only do NVE. Some people say it gives them more clarity of this and that. Again, it all depends on what you're looking to get out of it. But if you want more stable but beautiful frames at the same time, I would not recommend multiplying multiple reshades. Just use one and go with it. And the last tip, which is actually something I'm gonna do after this video. If you keep just getting crashes, if you've done all these steps, it's still not working, when is the last time you install GTA 5 and or 5M? If it's been a while, things do end up just running slower. Nothing beats a fresh install. That's actually what I'm gonna do right now. So these have been like five steps with three bonus ones to make your 5M and GTA 5 run smoother. If this video helped you out, help me out. I'm really trying to get to 40,000 subscribers for the year 2025. We're at 31,600 as the making of this video. Please help your boy out by subscribing to the channel, liking, and if you like 5M content, I got plenty of that for you on my channel. With that being said, my name is Yurtas, and I am out. See you guys.